epidemics, the damage comes from other people and the microbes spreading through their blood and breath. Natural disasters bring communities together, but outbreaks tear them apart. They make people frightened of their neighbors. To counter that, communities need clear-headed leaders, reliable information, and a unifying spirit. Trump is now president. When he faces his first major epidemic, as his predecessors have, he will likely project his impulsivity, xenophobia, and cavalier attitude towards facts to over 52 million followers with a speed that no virus could match. The president's readiness to buy into conspiracy theories could sway a populace that during the time of Ebola were already prone to disproportionate paranoia. His tendency to label what he disagrees with as fake news will zip through social media networks that are already struggling to stop malicious parties from seeding inaccurate information to vulnerable people. And his isolationist rhetoric will spread among an America already polarized by extreme partisanship and a world increasingly given to nationalism. Such nationalism could be catastrophic because diseases demand global cooperation. Viruses spread too easily. No travel ban will stop them. No wall, no matter how big or beautiful, will hold them back. So the best way of preventing pandemics is to contain outbreaks before they get a chance to spread. The US cannot possibly consider itself protected if other nations are not. America first cannot mean America alone.